Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Northeast Texas Sports Network. It's your boy Brett Swinney here for this second episode of NETSN News. Guys, it's been a while since we've talked from NETSN, and I'm hoping everyone's having a good evening. And we've got some exciting things to announce this evening. First off, what is NETSN News? It's a new kind of show that we're going to do when we have some big news to announce here on the network. We're not going to talk matchups in this one. We're not going to talk who's going to be at the top of the polls. We'll talk about that very soon. But tonight, it's going to be focused on some big things we've got coming up. First thing on the agenda, football season is here, ladies and gentlemen. Football season is here. We've got some schedule things we want to talk about this evening. First off, NETSN will continue to cover the Chapel Hill Bulldogs this season on Texan Live. The video streams will be there every week for your enjoyment. It'll be myself and Keith Whitman bouncing back and forth with games. Keith will be joining us in the booth for football season. Those of you that got to hear him call some basketball and baseball, softball games in the spring, Keith will be back with us. Some nights we'll be teaming up. Some nights he'll be somewhere and I'll be somewhere. And we'll talk about that here in just a second. But something new that we're going to bring this year, full-time Chapel Hill football will be on NETSN as well with an audio-only version. You'll have the same play callers, same color commentary guys. Everything will be the same as Vince joins us, but it will be a audio-only version for your entertainment. And for those of you who like the band, we'll have a video halftime show for the band. We're not allowed to do that on Texan Live, but on our channel we can do that. So Vince is going to be in the booth with us this year. Vince, are you excited about football season we got coming up?
I am. It's been a while. So I'm getting pretty excited the closer we get. So it's been a long wait, I feel like, since the last game I saw anyway. So
yeah. Your man Eddie's here. He's ready to talk to you tonight.
Oh, Vince. Eddie. I don't want to talk to Eddie.
Like I said, we've got some new personalities this year. We've got some familiar faces. We got some guy named CM that's joined us in the building. I like your hat, CM. That's CM edition.
Going on. Appreciate
it. We're just talking about the ability to be able, we're gonna have more personalities in the booth this year. We've got the audio option for the Chapel Hill streams here. What do you think about that, Corey? Having the option to not, if we don't want to go and pay, you can watch for free on NETSN.
I wish it was free for everybody to go watch, but it's not. But hey, you know, radio's a dinosaur, but hey, you can still watch it. We're not radio personalities, but you can still watch it, you know, or listen to it wherever you are.
And you'll have the scoreboard. You'll have, you know, the still be sponsored by our title sponsor of the network, Azalea Orthopedics. Don't forget about those guys. Mm-hmm. And so you'll have that broadcast. But that's not all this year, guys. We'll have those 10 games of Chapel Hill plus some, I'm sure, as they'll make a pretty deep run in the playoffs, I'm sure. But I'm going to bring in a special guest to make this next announcement. We're going to have Brook Hill football on NETSN this year, fellas.
All right.
And we got the Swiss Army knife of Brook Hill with all the different titles. But we know him from the basketball court, Corey. Yes. Mr. Jeremy Hubbard, also one of our people that come on off the ropes on DSN. Jeremy, welcome.
Man, glad to be with you tonight. And glad to have you guys coming out, man. I was telling somebody today when you guys came in basketball season and the energy you brought to the gym, number one, and the fact that our kids have a chance to watch themselves later and people that are not there get to come in and watch. And it was a no-brainer for us when you guys wanted to jump in and help us out during football season. It was a no-brainer, and we're super pumped about that.
Yeah, we love the – I know we said it a billion times over. We love the atmosphere. Y'all got something special going on. That was the first time I've ever been to the gym. Been to that gym in Brook Hill, and I'm like, man, I like this place. It's loud, and you can't really talk, you know, across from me if it's, you know, if everybody's, you know, pumped up. And then of course the student section is, the bodyguard, the student section.
Man, that's crazy. Yeah, I got warned about the student section when I showed up.
if that gets patented, we need some credit in creating that our students say.
No, I told you, Brett, the other day, like, it was too late for me to hear this. I didn't know that CM started that thing until after the season was over with. If I'd have known that, we'd have had to figure something out. I'd have been a t-shirt or something. And stuff.
Yes.
No, it's, you know, in the gym's great. I tell you, if you haven't been to a football game at our place, broadcasting or not, with the tailgate that we do before the games and then the student section there and all the fan support we always get and our home schedule, I know you're going to talk about that some, Brett, but the teams that we have coming in to our stadium this year, we feel like are going to bring a lot to the table also, and should be some exciting nights out there at Harrington Stadium. And, it's funny because July 4th happens, Corey, and it's time for football season. Like, it's time to go, and it's getting on us quick.
Yeah, I missed the Big 12 media the other day or this week. I've been watching NBA Summer League. I'm sorry.
Me too.
I haven't quite gotten to the football just yet, but NBA Summer League's been on my TV. It's on now. So,
well, and we've got, and Jeremy mentioned those. We're going to do four home games this fall, goes with Brooke Hill. We've got the first one we'll have is the, week two of the season. We'll have Brooke Hill versus Dallas Life Oak Cliff. That'll be, I think, September 1st. And Vince, you'll be on the call of every one of those Brooke Hill. Tell us about excitement about Brooke Hill football.
I'm excited. I can't wait. I'm hoping I can get, you know, a roster sheet or something kind of early. Maybe I get a little special treatment. They can send me some information.
I got you, man.
I appreciate it. Probably a t-shirt too. I'm just throwing that out there.
I got you. You let me know.
Yeah, some merch. He's out looking for some merch. Look at there. Hey, yeah. Anything would be better than that Texans hat you got on your head there, Vince.
Oh, so, man. I actually had my NETSN hat, and I said, I'm taking that off. I'm going to wear my Texans hat. Man.
I thought that was first a NETSN hat. I was like, I like that first.
Yeah, that's not one. Maybe you should design one like that, Corey.
I like that hat. I was like, man, that needs to have a NETSN hat like
version
that.
Like, but this? You know, yeah, that'd be
dope. Yeah, I liked it. I liked it.
But, yeah, pretty excited about the Brooke Hill season. So I get to do four games. I'm blessed to do four games with Whitman. I think he's doing three with me. And then, Brett, you're doing one with me. Is that right?
I think it's going to be me and you on two of them and you and Keith on the other.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So we're going to split them. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm pretty excited, though, about the season. You got anybody to look out for this season that you want to point out? Yeah.
And we got a bunch. I do want to warn you. Brett may not have told you this. So, being a boarding school, we have guys from all over. I know two of my starting defensive linemen are going to be from Finland, and good luck with those names. I just yell at them. I say, hey. Obviously our quarterback, Jonah McCown, Luke McCown's son is there. And okay. Jonah actually picked up his first Division I offer today to North Alabama. And we're excited about that. And, man, it's going to be a good year. It's going to be a different year for us. We have a lot of, we lost a big group in terms of the role they played last year. Okay. But we have some guys who have been getting a lot of reps and a lot of snaps, and they're ready to step in and go. And we're really excited about it. You know, the Oak Cliff game, we picked up those guys late last year. We had a team drop us, and it just kind of worked out where we met up. And, you know, their style of offense is really explosive. They like to play fast and chunk it all over the place, which is a challenge for any defense. We were fortunate last year to win the game convincingly, but that first game is what we call our American Warrior Bowl, and there's a lot of stuff that goes on around that. We recognize vets or first responders before the game on the field, and that'll be something you guys will be able to get on camera and check that out. But it's just an amazing night. Of course, we have a very strong, I don't want to say military background necessarily, but as our founder and our staff, very history minded. And so a lot of cool things happen that first night. And it's usually week zero or week one, whatever you want to call it now, but it's our second week is our first home game. And we're excited about that. And then, Vince, you get the big rivalry game in week three, following that one, when Grace comes to town. Case you're wondering,
and I'll be
no love lost. Yeah,
I'll be there for that one as well. So
you can throw out everything about who's good and who's bad. It's just a battle, and the last you know, we were fortunate 2 years ago to put it on them pretty good. But other than that, it's been, you know, the team winning at the half has not won the game the last few times other than that. So it's kind of been one of those back and forth deals. It's been fun. And I think the other games you're doing, you'll have Atlanta, Brett, is that right? I think in week five.
We'll have Atlanta. Well, yes, Atlanta.
And that's a sneaky good football team. You know,
they're gonna give y'all some trouble. They have always have good athletes in Atlanta.
Well, and they're big. You know, honestly, growing up in East Texas, that's kind of what my thought was these guys are gonna be super athletic, and can we run with them? And I'll be honest with you, I'd have rather them ran by us a few times last year than run over us. They're just huge. And they you know, Tyler Morton, their new head coach, came from Arkansas, and he just brought a whole different style to Atlanta.
Yeah.
And it was we lost by six last year. We, you know, we were driving at the end of the game, and they got a big fourth down stop, and we lost. But, you know, that's going to be a fun one. And then I think Dallas Christian, our last home game of the year, you guys will be there too. And hopefully in the postseason you'll be with us. So Dallas Christian's two-time defending state champion. They're the biggest challenge on our schedule anytime. And so it's a challenge. It's senior night for us that night. And you know, whatever happens, happens. But – we're excited about going forward, and like I said, pumped you guys are going to be there for all that, and you know, as much as I'm dreading the grind of the season, like I'm getting excited talking to you. Like I'm sitting talking all these games, I'm ready to go right now.
Well, let me ask you real quick. I don't want to put you on the spot, but do you have a prediction for your season this year? Like, what kind of record you'll end up with this year?
You know, I'll say this: Coach Ryle's always done a good job of making sure our non-district schedule is pretty tough. He wants us to be ready for the district schedule. So our first game of the year is against Grapevine Faith, a team on the road that beat us pretty handily last year. They kind of – I don't want to say we took them lightly, but we weren't ready for some things that they did. And they took it to us pretty good. That's going to be a challenge for us. And Life Oak Cliff, I think, is a game that's a very winnable game for us if we, you know, play the way we should. Grace is always a tough game. Atlanta, we play White Oak on the road in there. And then our district – All Saints was in our district and dropped out last year in football, so they're playing an independent schedule. Dallas Shelton, another school, dropped out. So there's only four of us in the district. We kind of know going in we're all going to be in the playoffs. But in TAPS, as Corey and Brett know from basketball, if you finish first or second, you get to host a playoff game. And the numbers have just shown that if you can host a playoff game, the numbers, you have a better chance of getting there. Yeah, and so We feel like we're a favorite to finish one of those top two spots. Obviously, we got some things to work through. We got a couple of good scrimmages with Rusk and with Grapevine, two teams that are very athletic and very physical and very well coached. And it could be a special year for us if things go well Corey and mentioned this a minute ago, but there are some things happening in our programs all around that we're really excited about. A new strength conditioning coach. It's kind of, man, our kids have worked hard this summer and have put themselves in great shape and are doing great things. And hopefully for you, it'll be entertaining to watch and be on the call. I know it's a lot better to be on a call of a good game, an exciting game, than a 7-3.
Give me some points any day.
Yeah, we're going to have to.
I will say this. I'm a fan of the facilities. I was jealous. I'm looking at the indoor facilities all connected. I'm like, man, I'd like a tour of that one day. That'd be really nice.
Hey, man, you let me know. It's funny. Last year there was a game, I think in the middle of the season, it was raining or something. And honestly, we use that in some of our practices. We are a big believer in if we can do something, let's do it. But mainly, let's get outside in the elements. But it was raining or something in pregame, and so we just went in there to warm up and let the other team go on the field. Well, and as coaches, you're always trying to just give your kids an edge. And we were cranking up. We had the AC/DC going in there and as loud as it can go. And the other team's out there in the rain warming up. And we're in there staying dry and warming up. And it's kind of something that stuck. And, you know, as you mentioned, you just need to come out and check out a Friday night one time when you get a chance, because the tailgate atmosphere in that back parking lot. And we enter the stadium through the tailgate. And it's just it's unbelievable, man. I'm very blessed and fortunate. I say this all the time. I am so blessed to be a part of what we're doing. We have great coaching staff and great kids.
Y'all got that kind of community thing right there. Yeah. And I know when I went through there, when we was going to watch the basketball games and stuff, and I was like, man, I imagine it must be pretty dope to go to a school like this. Do you feel like you just drive into your own little city you know.
Yeah, and our kids, I'm so happy that our kids understand how fortunate they are to be in those situations. Obviously private schools get a bad rap for a lot of things, right? And there's kind of this, I hope at least Corey and Brett saw this, and Vince, you've seen this. There's this negative connotation sometimes with private schools and what that means. And, man, our kids, they love football and love competing just as much as everybody else, and they work just as hard as everybody. I mean, we're going to go out there. We have midnight practice on the first night, and we're going to get after it. And it's
anything like basketball, Jeremy, I mean, y'all had one of the best atmospheres that we were a part of last year.
I enjoyed the basketball atmosphere.
You're going to love football too, guy. I mean, it's truly special. And, I know there's a lot of places that do great things, and I'm not knocking any of that, but I would – there's not many places I'd rather be on a Friday night than at Brook Hill for a home game. It's kind of a letdown when we go on the road. Like, it's – where's the tailgate? Where's the – I mean, it's perfect.
Yeah, everybody don't have that atmosphere. Yeah, I like that,
yeah. Well, I love Friday night games.
Uh-oh.
And I love Friday night games. I am still pushing for Saturday games in East Texas. They got to be some kind of Saturday atmosphere.
Okay,
I know it's college football, but it's beautiful. Like a beautiful Saturday, there's nothing like a noon Saturday kickoff. That's some good stuff.
Corey, I'm gonna tell you, it's not far away, and I'm not breaking any news here, but with the official shortage, especially in East Texas, I'm just telling you, it's coming the next couple of years. You see a lot of teams now. Like I know week one, there's a couple of big small school games on Thursday night because.
Yeah.
Even the good smaller school teams can't get referees on Friday night, so it's tough. And we've been fortunate that we haven't had to move a lot. I think it was the year before COVID, so I guess that's the fall of 19. We actually had Albany, right, who's an all big time, two-way school. We met up and needed a game, and so they came in our place and played it Saturday on 2:00, and I loved it. I know. From a coaching standpoint, it makes the next week difficult if you have a Friday night game.
Right.
But at the same time, I'm with you, man. Like we set up our own college game day set up and had parents doing that and our tailgate, and it was. But I'm with you, man.
NETSN game day at Brook Hill.
Hey, man.
NETSN game day at Brook Hill.
We've done it. You bring the trailer, baby. We'll have it ready for you.
If y'all got a tailgate party, I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna get there early.
Hey, man, that may be the only way to get Vince to a game early.
Yeah, if you got some ribs, some something.
I'm gonna tell you. Listen, we're getting all excited about football. Hey, listen, I don't know where CM's gonna be on most Friday nights, but I know where he's gonna be now because we have guys, and this is the craziest thing. So obviously, as coaches, we're with our kids, and we're trying to get them ready for the game, and we kind of give them that dead period between about 4 and 5:15-ish to kind of rest and lay around. And some of us sometimes will sneak out there because it's one of those things to where there are guys with – they're bringing in these barbecue trailers and they're cooking things. They're like, hey, man, what do you want? And I'm like, man, I got to coach a game. I can't be out here eating sausage links, right?
So I
might be doing all four of those games too. I might be
– Hey, here it goes. Here he goes. Is that the guy at the Frito Pot? It's him.
It's nuts, man. It's nuts.
Here's the thing, Jeremy. We're appreciate you guys at Brook Hill. We've got a really good relationship with you guys, and we're glad that we can cover your guys' athletes, male and female, pretty much of all the sports that we cover.
Yeah.
And so this will be their first full year with y'all, and I know we did a little bit of basketball, and Keith covered the hound dog out of you guys in baseball and softball. This year it's going to grow. We're going to have more basketball games for you guys and also you guys' tournaments. So we're excited. And thanks. And speaking of that, we're going to talk next a little bit. We got some new shows coming down the pipe. Isn't it something else to break on NETSN News? One of them is going to be a Brook Hill show, Jeremy, and kind of give the people a little bit of insight on what the Brook Hill show or whatever we end up calling it is going to be about.
Yeah, maybe we should just call it the whatever show. I don't know, but. No, we're excited about that. I think this is something that as a school we've really wanted to do to find a way to highlight our kids and what they're doing and our coaches and what they're doing because we feel like our people is our biggest asset in terms of what we do. And so just a chance each week for Coach Ryle during football season and related but not my wife, Coach Hubbard, to be the volleyball coach to be on and a couple of kids, every week to kind of talk about not just the game and the results, because we're going to have that out there, but just to kind of talk about the high school experience of an athlete, sometimes we forget that those kids are doing homework and they're having tests and they have you know, boyfriend, girlfriend, all those things go on, and that plays into being a high school athlete. And so we're excited about that. I was telling you off the air that our head football coach, Scott Rao, who is, you know, one of the best in the business, he is super excited about a chance to showcase the program in a new way every week, other than just people coming to a game and watching. And you guys are right, all the special things that go on there. And I was telling somebody this yesterday, like, we have a lot of things and we're doing some big stuff and we're building a new building and all. But, man, it truly is about the people that we have. And we feel like that just the chance to get some of our people out there in the public eye and see what they're thinking. And then I think that just, I mean, you guys know this in every level of sports. If you get a chance to hear from an athlete or hear from a coach and get to know them better, you find yourself just more interested in what they're doing. And that's what we're truly hoping to accomplish. And you know, honestly, anytime – to me, if you're a high school coach and you're not trying to promote your kids any way you can, you're doing them a disservice, especially in 2023 when there's all kind of avenues to get their name out there and what they're doing.
Yeah.
And that's where you guys, you know, that's where you guys come into play. I know your heart, and that's kind of where you're at. You want kids that's to be recognized for what they're doing. Yeah, and so we're just glad that we're going to get that opportunity. And we don't know what we're calling it yet. We'll figure it out as we go.
Meet me at the Brook. I don't know. Something like that.
I can think of something.
Meet me at the Brook.
I can think of something.
Yeah, I'll have something by the end of the night.
but no, we're excited about that. 12 o'clock
at night, and that light bulb will come out.
Yeah, text midnight, not me. I'm going to be asleep. I ain't going to lie.
Everybody knows I'll be up. I'm up late. Y'all probably get late texts from me all the time. Like, dang it, what's Brett doing up still? He needs to go to bed.
Yeah.
He's on his phone.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah, our brainstorming something about something new we want to come out with, because we're always trying to do something innovative here at NETSN. Mm-hmm. And we've got – that's not the only new show. We're going to have Beast from the East podcast coming on to NETSN. It's going to be kind of – Terry at L4 Media and S2S Sports is kind of, you know, letting us have that. We'll be at the coaches clinic this next week. So anyone that's going to be there, come by the L4 Media booth. I'll be there. Me and Terry will be doing some interviews and kind of shaking hands and talking to coaches. So we'll be doing that show. Well, of course, our weekly wrap-up show is not going anywhere. Me, Vince, Kyle, and Corey will be doing that every Wednesday night. Same time, same channel, right? We're not changing the channel. We're not going to change the name of it, right? Still NETSN. Mm-hmm.
Unless we let an Ocho at the end. It's in the Ocho.
That's paid for.
Same time, same channel.
It's in the Ocho.
We're also going to have another thing that me, Corey, and Vince are excited about. The Old Dog Show is coming to NETSN, fellas. We're going to be talking with Coach Ridgen every week, and then either a couple of players, and then Corey, me, and Vince will be talking just Chapel Hill football. For those that kind of started with us at Bulldog Sports Network, we're going to give you a show that's going to throw the NETSN out for a second, and we're going to be partisan Chapel Hill Bulldog fans, and we're going to talk the meat gritty of the season. So that's what's going to be right now. We may do some other things on the show at some point. We've looked at the possibility of having alumni come back and interview and talking. We've got some good ideas. Corey's trailer that he produced was very excellent, so shout out to Corey. He's got everybody really ready for football season. Every time I watch it, it gives me chills. I'm ready for the season to start. So that's going to be exciting for us. Is there any other shows we're doing that y'all can think of right now?
You know, I don't know, Desmond. Yeah, that's a lot of stuff. You know, I just want to say I'm getting hyped about this year. There's a lot of stuff that we have planned, a lot of stuff that we want to do. Like I said, this is kind of this is year three of everything right now. Year three of NETSN, or year three of year two or three. I can't remember. God, whatever.
It's year two.
Whatever. Zero,
year
zero,
two.
Whatever.
Year two.
All right. And it feels like it's year three. But, you know, we're kind of scratching the surface on what we actually want to do. And as we build relationships with a lot of communities and schools and coaches, we would love to do a lot more documentary work, you know, behind the scenes work, day in the life stuff, you know, season stuff, you know, just kind of getting and building personalities. It helps in recruiting, you know, if a coach wants to see what you're really like, you know, it helps in that aspect. You know, some coaches are really, you know, what some coaches are like personally. You know, I don't want to get in your personal life, but, you know, just everyday stuff. I like that type of stuff. I think, you know, it doesn't – East Texas doesn't have that type of draw at the moment, but I'd love to see that happening, and I'd love to get that started. So I'm anxious to see what that's going to bring. If we can kind of get that – it may not be this year, but hope we can get that started pretty soon.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, and Eddie's your stats man.
Yeah,
Jeremy. So he's got you. He's got your stats already projected. Record at 8-1 with 2-1 district. I think you would take.
We would take it. Yeah, I tell you what. If we finish this year, now we got a 10th game now that
founders because you're thinking your one is Dallas. I think you would sign that right now.
No matter who the one is, if we finish this year,
you finish 8-1. That's good.
As the old defensive coach, defensive line coach, I'm gonna tell you, if we finish with one loss, I did something right, so I'm gonna be happy. So, anyway, no, Corey, hey, listen, before I get out of here, I'm gonna tell you, man, I told Brett, my door is always open, man. You, whatever you want to do, I have the same heart you do. I appreciate everything you guys do, and our kids and any kids, I'll do anything we can to get them out there because you're right, man. Like, it does nothing but help them. It does nothing but help them. And so, you guys have accessed us anytime you need it. You just let us know.
We appreciate it.
Cool. Thanks.
We appreciate it.
Well, we appreciate it. And there was something else that we were supposed to talk about tonight. I think –
I really want to thank you for coming here and seeing it with us today. We're really, really proud of it. Everybody's worked really hard on it. So thank you. Oh, wait a minute, though. Wait a minute. I forgot. There is one more thing. I forgot to tell you about. This is really important. So thank you very much for coming today. We've had a lot to show you. Thanks for sitting through a long presentation. Oh, but wait a minute. Wait a minute. I do have one last thing I forgot to tell you about. So thank you for coming today and checking this out with us. We're very, very pleased to introduce this to you. And, wait a minute now. There is one more thing.
There is one more thing, fellas. One more big thing that we need to talk about tonight. And I kind of music to go with it. Here we go.
It was China or Russia for a second.
Stop, no. Stop. Drop. Shut them down. Open up shop. Oh, no. That's how rough fighters roll.
The one more thing, fellas. Rough Rider Sports is joining NETSN. That means is that cast all year long here on NETSN. And to talk about it, we're going to bring in our boys from the old Rough Rider Sports. We got Chris Wallington and Steven Shires. Welcome, fellas.
That's the way Rough Riders roll.
What's going on?
Steve Jobs, he pulled that trick on us two or three times at Apple, and I'm glad you got that. Those clips. Steve was one of our good friends, and he would always leave us to the end. That's pretty cool.
Absolutely.
I know you never.
We're glad to be here.
They kind of continue that a little bit, but that one more thing is huge, and that's you guys. And so I'm kind of turn over to y'all. Chris Wallington, he's in the left, to my left, I guess, on screen, and Shire's up top in the corner. But just kind of each of you introduce yourself, give your story of where y'all started and kind of what got you here with us tonight.
Okay, I'm Chris Wallington. This is Steve Shires, the counselor. And I just graduated from college, and I'm really looking forward to this.
Well, our first thing is to say we're so excited to join the NETSN. and family, and just for all the things that are going on, and we've been doing this for a little bit. Chris has been doing this for
31 years, just out of college. But when we started, when I was in my 20s, my partner Rob Payne, who you will meet as part of our team in football anyway, started doing Rough Rider radio games. I guess it was the 1993 season. We thought we'd do it for a couple of years, and we just kept doing it. And when 10 or 12 years into that, we picked up a young counselor, Stephen Shires, who had moved back from a big law firm in Houston, and he came back to center to take over the county.
They needed a good-looking sideline reporter.
And we couldn't find one, so Stephen was who we went with. And he's been, I mean, we've been doing Rough Rider games for 20 years, the two of us, and, you know, with Rob, 30 years. But during COVID, when the whole video thing became a possibility, Shires figured it out. We were able to show some Rough Rider games to fans that couldn't go. And then from there, it's just kind of taken off. And we're doing basketball, and we've done some tennis and baseball. And we were hoping to work softball in, and soccer. We cover soccer as best we can. We don't know anything about it, but as best we can. So we've had a really, really good time with it. And then we met Brett Swinney when we were going to do a Chapel Hill basketball game, and really from there, Shires, the history changed.
Yeah, we started talking, and it turns out that we kind of share the same kind of vision and goal for where we wanted to see everything go as what Brett was doing. And we've got a roster of characters like you guys have. We've got, obviously, we have Rob. He's kind of the ultimate straight guy. We have Larry.
We have a Rob too.
Yeah.
Everybody's got a Rob.
Yeah. Everybody's got a Rob somewhere.
Our Rob is from the planet Vulcan, though.
Yeah, so. Yes.
Real straight.
We've got we just recently picked up another gentleman by the name of Larry Pierce. He's the opposite of Rob. He's as a matter of fact, you know, we have ref, because that's his favorite thing.
Yeah, and we also have a mute button.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
He gets excited, but he's great at what he does.
But over time, we have probably about six or seven guys that rotate in. We have a fellow by the name of Chris on the Mayfield. There's Chris Mayfield, but he's on his own air personality. He's Chris on the Mayfield, because he does sideline reporting now too. Son,
nice.
He's no better looking than I am. Matter of fact, he's
well. We were all radio people. This video thing caught us all off guard. We had to start losing weight.
Yeah, and so what we do is we cover the, like Chris said, the Center Rough Riders, and that's football, and we're able to live stream the games directly. The regular season games. And that includes just like what Brett was talking about. We cover the band. We cover the cheerleaders. We have student interviews. We try to get as many of the students involved as we can.
Because when I started, I was, for most of that 30 years, I was a teacher in center. And so I had access to all the students. And I thought, you know, cheerleaders, dancers, the folks that are the trainers, they never get any radio time. So we made sure we worked their stories into our broadcast, just because I felt like that was the right thing to do. Well, now I'm retired from the school, and it's a lot harder to get used to. I would just go to their third period class and wait for the bell to ring, you know, my conference period, and say, hey, come here. A little harder to do that now, but we still try to do that.
Right.
Yeah.
And of course we're in so we do football, basketball, baseball, softball, soccer. Like Chris says, we do tennis. We have a good tennis program here, and have had a historically good program for 25 years.
But center is an underserved team and really city for media goes. We're a little too far south to get a whole lot of Tyler TV attention. A little too far north to get the Lufkin TV attention. So, you know, we're kind of the only show in town until we met you guys. And we're really excited to kind of bring what we do to y'all and then share what you guys do with our folks. I think it's going to be a really fortuitous combination. I think I'm really looking forward to it. And then once we get to the playoffs, we're hoping to bring some really good area teams, smaller schools in our county, the Shelbyvilles, the Timpsons, the Tenahas, and the Joaquins that have state runs in different sports. And of course, they have nobody covering them either. And I think some of those teams would be teams that your viewers would be interested in too.
Absolutely. I mean, what would we guarantee
you guys? And I was going to say, just for the football, just for example, just because we're kind of talking football tonight, I mean, every one of the teams that you kind of have on your schedule, I think we've probably had them in some form or fashion, the coverage. I mean, your Bullards, your Tatum. Carthage, you play Tatum? Rudd.
Tatum.
It's going to work well this year.
A lot of them.
Yeah, the Tatum game last year was incredible. We won. The Center Rough Rider season last year was incredible because we started the season with a four overtime game and ended the season with a five overtime loss.
I think it was exactly the same. I'm pretty, the new overtime rules this past season were instituted. We didn't even know what they were. And on the very first game, I think we were the first four overtime game under the rules in the state, an exciting win. And then I'm sure we were the first four overtime loss in the playoffs in the state. Heartbreaking and exhilarating both to bookend our season. So it was kind of like, I wish ESPN had been covered.
So we're just excited. And then we're also kind of like y'all guys are doing
here at 9-1.
Yes. Well, that's interesting because we'll just like you guys said with Brooke Hill, we'll take the 9-1. We'll take that. We'll lock that in.
Hey, I wanted to know. Hold on. Now, y'all understand Eddie. Eddie's like a snake, man. You play with him too long, he gonna bite you.
I wouldn't
buy into it. Now, I'm not saying I'm about to sneeze. I'm just saying, Eddie'll get you.
The good news about a 9-1 record means that we're either going to beat Carthage or there's this team or the North DeSoto team that's on our schedule. They were an incredible football team. I think they made it to the semifinals last year.
And they're a Louisiana team, so not a lot's known about them. That's a game to tune into. They scored – they played so fast they managed to – how many points did they score? 70-something?
Yeah.
And it was so unbelievable how quickly they got to the ball. It was a whole different brand of ball.
There were a lot of points scored in Rough Rider games by both – a lot of teams last year.
Yeah, I think we scored 40-something and got beat by 30.
It's crazy. But that team was incredible. And of course, you have Carthage, which is
– I was going to say, there's going to be a lot of crossover, I'm sorry, too. Because you're good. It's because you got Ricky Joe Meeks. His dad was a state championship coach at Chapel Hill, where some of our listeners are, obviously, that listen to us. And so you've got that connection with Center. I got to teach Ricky this week, and he's – you guys joining us, and we're going to have him on one of our shows at some point during the season because you got Square here that knows him. Sure. He says he's got the boys looking great. So, Eddie agreed with you. He agreed with you on one of those. I'm not sure if it may be in the Louisiana team.
But you're right. This is the third year. This is Coach Meek's third year of administration. So I really think, the first year was kind of rough, and then we turned it around and had a great season last year. And I think we're going to build on that momentum, and it's going to be – we're really looking forward to the season.
And Coach Meeks has brought in young guys that want to work with him, but he's also brought in some people my age, and they're – that graduated in the 80s because they worked for his dad. And they're at the end of their careers and wanted to come work for Ricky Joe because they remember – what a great thing the Meeks experience was. So there's a lot of excitement in Center because of that.
Okay.
All right. Then, so I was going to say, y'all talked about possibly doing a coaches show. That's another show that I didn't want to mention earlier, but the very good chance that you guys are going to have a show. Tell us what your thoughts are. I know you've had a couple of years that y'all have wanted to do this. What are your thoughts on what that's going to entail?
Well, we would like to visit with Coach Meeks, obviously, and then let him choose to bring a coach and a player on. And then according to how much time we want to give to it, to the actual length of the show, maybe feature one of those cheerleader band students and just give them a chance to be bragged on as well. But that's kind of what we've been wanting to do for a long time. We did that on radio some in the past, but we haven't done it on video yet.
Yeah, just come in and give a quick breakdown of the, you know, the prior game, and you know, and then highlight the athletes that really showed out, and then you know, and then have, you know, some amount of analysis about what to expect the next week, you know, without giving away too many secrets.
Well, the good news is those games now, those links are now available on YouTube. I've made them public, so all you center fans out there, go subscribe to NETSN. Come on over and join us. I mean, we'll be sharing this video out, but the links are there for those games. And I'm gonna throw it to Vince and Corey. You guys got any questions for these guys?
I will ask you the same question I asked Jeremy earlier. What is your expectation of the season? Where do you think you'll fall? Like, as far as like a record, like you have an idea of what you might end up this year?
Well, what's interesting, I mean, if you see our schedule, you know, we've got Dangerfield on in the pre-district, and we went up there and gave them a shellacking last year. And so
that was when we kind of realized we might have something.
You know? So I imagine
I remember that game.
I will say that. When I saw the Dangerfield score, I said, uh-oh.
But, you know, this is another year, and I suspect those fellows up there are going to remember what happened, and they're going to come down to center probably looking to get a little bit of revenge,
I would think. Yeah.
You know, and the like I said, the Tatum game could have gone either way. We won, like I said, I think four overtimes, and we won it on a goal line stand, stopped them from going in.
We won it by, you know, 13 inches. You know, it was just very exciting. Yeah. So who knows? I felt like we got stronger during the year, and Tatum struggled to keep that kind of level of play. But you know, it's a whole new year. Who knows? Right.
We had a big disagreement about that team and Tatum. And Brett was ultimately right about them. I mean, they did have a tough schedule, but the way I was looking at it, I was like, man, you play too many close ones and you keep losing them. I don't know if that means you're good or not. I'm just basing it off the fact that you lost them all. So. But Brett was right. They were a tough team to play, and they went out fighting. So, but I think
I'm gonna snip that recording out, Vince. I'm about to snip that and then
as one time, I'll never say it again.
That was correct.
the thing about our district, of course, you have Carthage, and Carthage is what it is. It's just excellence. I mean we. Surratt, you know that what you're going to get with them is, which is a solid football team that's very good, but the rest of our teams in the district, there was no night off. I mean, we won several of the games handily, but it didn't have to be that way. And then I think a couple of the teams like Bullard and Brownsboro, you know, they were kind of lower down, but they ended up getting some victories, and then we went to Rusk and got it handed to us. So I mean, it's a pretty balanced district. You better bring your game every week in district, or you'll be disappointed.
So in answer to your original question, I would think if we could go pre-district with one loss, mm-hmm. and district with one loss, and go 8-2, it would improve on last year, and it would put us in the number two spot in the district, which, I mean, I think that's where we ended up last year too. And it helped. Yeah. But
I'll tell you this. If you go 1-9 and only beat Carthage,
automatic playoffs. Automatic playoffs.
They're 25 miles north of us. You know, we're roughly the same size schools. But, you know, there were such natural rivals. But, I mean, we haven't beaten them since 2005. Very few people have beaten them since 2005. So, a win against Carthage would be a deal.
Well, this could be a year to get them.
Yeah.
This could be a year to get them, guys, because they did lose quite a bit.
That's true.
I know they'll still be really good. Yeah. But they're going to get better off of this, because you got Coach Surratt's sons and going to be the starting quarterback now. So, they're going to get – better. So I think if you're going to grab a year, this is a year Carthage is vulnerable. I don't want to say that too early, but it could be. So, you know, y'all, if you now you, and you got Coach Meeks.
Carthage is going down.
Yeah. I predicted a center victory right here, baby.
That's a hot take.
I am too.
That's Corey. Corey, you predicted that. You picked center over Carthage last year. Are you going to double down on that?
I did pick. I mean, honestly, it looked pretty good on paper. I mean, they
it looked pretty good for about a quarter and a half. Yeah, we had it right where we wanted it about the second quarter.
Yeah.
Right. No, I mean, if you can keep the game, if you can keep the game within 50 points, you're all right. That's a win.
Yeah. But, no, what was crazy?
They scored. That's the best defense they played besides the Gilmer game all year.
Yeah.
So they didn't just select you guys. They earned that win. So, and I didn't think, I'm sounding stupid. They won a state championship. I didn't think they were as good as they've been in the past.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm going to say that.
Yeah. Quite a compliment to that program. They were down a little bit this year. All they did was win the state championship.
We came out and just took the ball and just jammed it right down their throat the first series to score a touchdown. And had them nervous, and then again it was we were in control, and then we had a couple of turnovers in the second quarter, and then we just couldn't recover.
And tell us how good is Dixon, guys? You've seen him in person. I mean, I understand he's grown a few inches.
Yes,
he's about 6'2" now. I mean, what kind of difference maker is he on the field for you guys?
As a former offensive lineman, you want to make your block, because I don't care if you're on the 10 or if you're on your 2. If you make your block and he gets into the secondary, he's gone. And there's nobody that's going to catch him.
And he's also big. I mean, he's kind of the full package. Yeah. He can run over you and run through you. But he started last year. He was a known factor with us and with the team. But he was kind of – the press was going to – a very good athlete that played receiver last year, Marmar Evans, and our quarterback. And so he kind of quietly impressed everybody. I mean, by the end of the year, everybody knew his name.
They're going to know him this year, in other words.
He really
is. Yeah. And the offensive line, I think the offensive line that we've got this year, I mean, is going to be solid. I think this is going to – we're going to see an overall improvement in that unit. Maybe not – a particular person, but I think the play of the offensive and defensive lines are where we're going to see a lot of the most improvement in year three under coach.
We got the man, the myth, the legend watching this. Nice to join us, Terry. Welcome. Yeah. So if you're going to sell your guys, I mean, he's got his Big Irish preview show up. You get a sell Terry on center, guys. Why should they be a contender?
Go ahead, Shire.
So we've got a 3-year Letterman quarterback who is a fantastic athlete. He can hurt you with his feet. He can flip the ball and it can go 40 yards. He's very smart. He really took care of the football last year. Very few turnovers. We've got a wide receiver that. He looks like a Division I athlete. He's going to be a Division I athlete. He's a track star. He's the fastest guy in the district. He is unbelievable. He can get down the field, and we got a guy that can throw it to him. So you're going to have to pay that attention. And then the aforementioned Caden Dixon, again, if you don't get him, if you don't bottle him up in the front seven, if he gets 4 to 5 yards down the field without anybody touching him, it can easily be 6. And then defense, I think we're going to see improvement in our front seven. I think another year of the weight program and the conditioning. I think we're going to be – that's the one thing that Ricky brings is when he was here before as assistant coach, I mean, we were a very physical football team and played a very physical brand of football. And he's bringing that back to a level that a lot of teams don't see anymore, is that physicality.
And finally – in kind of the tiebreaker, we are the only 4A school, I believe, in the state of Texas with a 200-member band.
All right.
That's probably right.
Well, yeah, I do have a nice band.
So the halftime show on NETSN is going to be great this year then. When you tune in.
Yes, it ought to be.
I'm excited. I'm a former band president, so I'm excited.
Sweet. Like good band.
Corey, you got any questions for the guys?
They've hit everything that I was kind of thinking about. Honestly, I'm just excited about the fact that, you know, now on Fridays, you know, I don't have to watch just the Chapel Hill. I can watch Brook Hill. I can potentially watch another school. And now I got Center. Yeah. I can watch. And not only that, you watch good quality football. This is state-ranked competition football. These are not Morgan. I'm excited about the North DeSoto. I had to look it up on the map where North DeSoto was in Stonewall. I'm like, so you guys are traveling there.
Yeah.
That's going to be nice. And we have a little bit.
That's a game. You ought to mark that one as one to
check
out.
That was an impressive team. And we're also working on, we don't have this finalized yet, but working, like we're talking about maybe doing, because we do have a big unit, kind of like you guys, try and get us a game of maybe an additional game of the week that we'll have on. I mean, because, and, you know, primarily we're going to try to get as many Timpson games that we can get. Because Bussy is a senior, so we're gonna get to enjoy him one more year.
Yes, and he hadn't committed to any Texas school yet.
Not yet.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Sark came to see him in the plane, baby, or the helicopter. So we'll see.
Hopefully, the burnt orange is better than the maroon and white. So.
That's what I'm hoping.
That's right. Baby.
2020. Oh, yeah, this is also made. They're also Texas fans, by the way. This is also a good.
Right. I attended the university, and I have two daughters that attended as well.
I would have attended the university if I had been smart enough.
Yeah. Well, I lived out there. I moved out there, and they wouldn't let me in the door. I tried. They're like, no, not you. So I went to the community college for a little while.
I'm not a shy guy, but I couldn't do the campus. I was like, I like UT. I'd like the sports group. No, I'm not keen on campus. I walked out and I was on the highway. I was like, where was that? It was like, it was a sub shop in a Starbucks. I was like, where's my class? I can't go to class at Starbucks.
It's a half a mile away and you got 10 minutes to get there.
Yeah. So, and there's no parking. There's no parking.
So guys, I got another question for you. So each making the move over to NSN, what are you guys most looking forward to joining us and being a part of our network?
And I'm easy. I like y'all, and doing this job is it's sports is important, and bringing sports to folks is important, and it unites communities, but it's really just a lot of fun. And the more people that you're around that kind of have the same passions that you do, it multiplies the fun. And I think it will multiply the fun for the people that we're serving. So that's one thing. But secondly, Brett, what you guys do technically is just remarkable. And I think what we do is going to be better because of that, for the benefits that you're going to bring to what we do. And what else?
No, I think you hit on it. I mean, the biggest thing to bring like-minded people in together. Again, I feel like y'all's vision and your mission and kind of what y'all stand for, it's the same thing that we stand for. And I think this is just a natural marriage of these two programs. And we will get together and we will become even stronger, because we will bring ideas for you guys, and y'all certainly have ideas. And then it's just more people with more ideas and more energy to do the whole thing. So we're just excited and appreciate the opportunity
more,
to be
it's more with you guys. Coverage. It's more coverage for us because you got territory in, you know, because our goal is the whole Northeast Texas area. So, we've got Kyle's coming over, and he's got that north area that he's got lots of connections. You guys down there south, we got the middle. And so the more we can expand and, you know, be able to cover more teams, then we can bring everybody in to, hey, you want to watch? Oh, there's how many games on NETSN? 3, 4, 5? Oh, okay. You got your choice. You need like 14.
And the other interesting thing is that because Center, I mean, this year we just happened to be the southernmost team and going north.
Right.
But there are many years, because we're right on the dividing line, there are many years where we're the northernmost team. And so we go south. And so the Jaspers of the world are all in our district a lot. And so, and basketball bring in, you know, some of the Lufkin area schools. And so
that's a whole different breed. And it would be fun. And of course, we're talking theoretically next year, we might go down there. But if we do, then, you know, we'll be able to share that with you guys as well.
Some good football, too. I appreciate the fact that, like I said, it's a great, great marriage. It just makes sense. I appreciate the fact that like minds, and we met before a couple of times. We met this past time, and on the way home, I was thinking, it's like we had a lot of like minds. Everything we were thinking was almost coincide. I was like, we got the same type of projected goals. I could see it here, and we could see it like this is perfect. That makes me feel like, okay, maybe we're on the right track with everything we're trying to do. And I keep saying, like, the network is there, but for me, growing up and watching East Texas sports, there's not a lot of coverage in East Texas. Every once in a while, KLTV or we'll get, you know, I don't want to name drop a news station. They're the only ones that cover here. But I mean, you got NFL stars everywhere. Yeah. Then there's no, you throw a rock, like I said, you throw a rock and hit a state champion.
How many state champions? Exactly.
And so there needs to be more coverage, more exposure to East Texas, and that's why the birth of this is here. So it's not just, like I said, it's not just a network for broadcasting sports. There's a lot of other wrinkles that we want to add to this. And so this is a great opportunity right now to grow. And if you guys are watching, eventually, if you guys, other people watching too, you know, we're always open for suggestions and looking to expand to other communities as well.
Well, I have a suggestion, a challenge for you guys. It doesn't have to be a recurring show, but we, at some point this year, we need one show where all of us are in the same room physically. We can just have a big old NETSN show. And then it'll be fun after the show to hang out because, you know, I mean, work on that.
I like the idea.
We're gonna let the Robs figure that out.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh no, don't do that.
That's a good inside joke. That's a good. No, but I think that's a good idea. That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. That's a very good idea.
Look forward to it, fellas. Thank you for including us.
No problem. I thought it was a good
idea.
I didn't get a chance to meet y'all personally last time, but
I heard good things. Corey told me that, you know, great things. Brett has told me great things. So I'm looking forward to it. So
we are too, man. Thanks for including us.
All right.
And again, we've got those links up. So this show over to you guys at Center. Hopefully we're able to grab a few of them, but sure, if not, we'll in their lives. Yes. So y'all welcome to share them out to whoever. We will do it. 25 games. I know we didn't go over it very often, but we did in our. So we've got 25 games up on YouTube there. So come out and you know, you can get notified when they go live.
That's how many games this year? That's one, and, two, three. I don't have that many fingers to count. That's
25. We'll have the 10 audio. It was a Chapel Hill, but those will be on text live for the video.
So technically, if you're not doing anything on a Friday,
regular season games.
You want to watch Center, a game where
Brook Hill and an ARP game, so streams.
Yeah. So I mean, I don't want to interrupt because I think it's a delay. I was saying, if you're not doing anything on Friday,
and there might be an easier
competition,
way,
you know,
coming soon too.
Yeah, Brett's kind of locking up a little bit.
Yeah.
It's retribution.
My, you know, well, there'll be any way to to find these games. Hopefully soon we'll talk more about that. But right now, youtube.com/NETSN Live that we have on the schedule. Corey, you go ahead, and I'll let you finish your comment since I'm
going to watch some. I'm not calling none. I'm watching some. That's all I'm doing.
That's all right. That's fine.
Oh, man. Well, fellas, appreciate y'all joining us tonight and making this official.
Yes.
We're gonna kind of go out in the same way we came in here with a little Rough Riders celebrating Center Rough Rider Sports and some other teams coming to NETSN. For Chris Wallington, Stephen Shires, Vincent Johnson, Corey Marshall, and Jeremy Hubbard from earlier from Brookhill, I'm Brett Swinney. This has been the NETSN News Edition Episode 2, talking football schedule 2023. Hope everyone has a great night. Good night, everyone.
Hey. I'm just glad you said this and not, you know, because I thought somebody hacked me. I'm sorry. I didn't know what the Steve Jobs thing. I got nervous, okay? I got nervous.
It kind of came out of nowhere for me.
I was like, no, it's really happening.